Hello everyone, welcome to Science and Tech series with Dr. Vedra. Topic for today's discussion is from health section. There is an important health milestone which is in news. So Africa has finally managed to just eliminate the polio from its continent. So now only just two countries are left in the world to just eliminate this dreaded disease which has affected lives of millions. African Regional Certificate Commission has formally noted that the last endemic country where polio cases were being detected has not detected any viral strain of polio in last 3 years. So officially now it can say with a lot of proud that its polio elimination program has now garnered the right attention, and Africa is now officially free from the viral strain of the polio. Yes, there are concerns that few cases of the polio vaccine induced polio are still there, which will be managed in due course of time. But the main angle, which was a wild strain, which has been eliminated, is altogether a reason for global community to appreciate this milestone. So in today's lecture, let's just decode briefly what polio is, what are the vaccines available, what are the system affected. Because a prelim question more or less is likely on, it can be asked on the basics of this disease. So let's decode the polio. First of all, for any disease to be decoded, the first and foremost is the causative agent. Which is the likely organism which causes polio? Is it some bacterial disease, viral or protozoan? So polio is caused by a virus, which is called the poliovirus. To be specific, it is a ribovirus. Ribovirus are the viruses which have RNA as genetic material. The single strand of RNA along with the proteins functions as a causative agent. We all know the viruses are the obligate parasites. They require a living host. In this case, there are no surprises, it's the humans. So the mode of transmission, it does not require any insect or some mammal to be transmitted to humans. It is through fecal-oral route, which happens to be the case with the contaminated food or water. So unlike the current corona, which is attributed to bats, or we can say the pangolins, there is no such reservoir of the animals in case of polio. It is directly transmitted to humans through contaminated food. So hygiene and sanitation play a critical role in managing this. Now coming to the types, because this is where the current affair part comes into the picture. There are three wild strains of polio which were affecting different parts of countries. They were type 1, type 2 and type 3. So type 2 was the first one to be eliminated way back in 1999. The type 3 strain was there in Nigeria. So this is important. Currently the type 3 strain globally was only found in the Nigeria, which was causing the rising in the cases. It has finally been eliminated. So currently the type 3 strain is now globally eliminated. The type 1 continues to be there in two countries. There is Pakistan and Afghanistan. So here you have to understand, out of the three wild strains, now only type 1 strain remains, which continues to be caused here in two Asian countries. So Africa, Southeast Asia, America, all have been free, but this region is one which is yet to achieve that milestone. The system affected is the nervous system. So this is important, where the nerves are affected, mainly the lower limbs as well, and then we see the paralysis of muscles, which can be fatal as well in case it happens to be a respiratory muscle. But those cases are quite less. So it is a disorder which needs to be managed because it leaves a mark for lifetime. And coming to the vaccine part, we all know how we are able to manage these such milestones. It's only due to the vaccination drive carried out on war footing. The success of oral polio vaccine is instrumental in such fight against the polio. So the initial credit goes to the Salk, Jonathan Salk, who developed the first ever vaccine. And then the current one, the oral polio vaccine, was developed by Salk. So this is where due to ease in administration and global acceptance, this has been the landmark milestone in the fight against the polio. And once it has been carried door to door campaign, there was no reason that examining. So this is where the historical part comes into the picture. And this oral polio vaccine is a live attenuated vaccine in which the strain is weakened so that it does not cause the disease. Nevertheless, once it is introduced, our immune system generates suitable antibodies to. So this is where at times it has been seen that when you are administering, due to mutations, some strains might just regain their pathogenicity and cause the infection. This one, the oral one, at times, in almost insignificant cases, can cause polio. So this one theme is yet to be eliminated. That's why we are now moving towards the injectable phase, which uses a dead attenuated vaccine in which there is no such live strain. So first you have to eliminate live strain, it was necessary to use the oral polio vaccine. Once that milestone is achieved, countries generally shift to the injectable phase because at then there is no chances that the vaccine is going to induce the virus. Now treatment, there is no such specific treatment for this disease, so we have to rely on that the old saying, prevention is better than cure. So this is one of the diseases where suitable treatment is yet to be found, and we must make sure that the vaccination is carried out in the right spirit. So this is what the polio is all about. So the current angle which from the perspective is that Nigeria, which was the lone country in the 47 countries in the regional commission which was reviewing, has finally managed to eliminate the wild strain type 3 to be precise from its country, and in process the whole Africa is now free of. There's another good news for Africa continent. There's another disease vector borne which we call sleeping sickness. Togo has recently become the first African country to successfully eliminate the sleeping sickness. So this sets the benchmark, and more countries are likely to follow the suit. We all know that trypanosomiasis, which is called the sleeping sickness, is spread by the vector CC fly, the intriguing insect which transmits that disease. This is what we have in today's health update. We'll be back soon with another, or you could say the more, on science and environment. Thank you very much. I hope this session was a quick revision for the disease in news. For any doubts related to polio or any other disease, you can ask them in comment section. Thank you.